Welcome back, and joining me now is Abhishek Pitti of Nucleus Vision. Abhishek, hi, thank you so much for joining us.
Well, thank you so much for having me.
Is India ready for blockchain to begin with? We, of course, have seen a lot of interest. There are many startups by hundreds that we've seen mushrooming up, entrepreneurs trying to be a part of blockchain technology in some sense. Is India ready, really?
I think the question is more about whether India is ready in what way. I think India is ready from a resource perspective. India is ready from a talent perspective. India is ready from an entrepreneurial spirit perspective. The question more about is there enough access to resources? I think that is where we are trying to step in and create that resource pool for the youth in India.
But what is your sense on the investment numbers? Because we are a minuscule when you look at the global investments that are going in for this technology.
We are 3 times United States in terms of scale. We are, I don't know, maybe 10x scale of Korea. So, and a lot of these geographies who have opened up really don't have that big scale either. So compared to what the other markets have done, I think India will lead and be one of the biggest contributors in this economy.
One part, of course, is funding. The other part, as you said, it's all external. It's all being spent on other platforms. Is it also because the regulatory framework isn't very clear? So you don't know where you stand until that is done.
I think the regulatory framework is not clear in many geographies. I think a lot of the countries have sort of similar stance. But there is an element that adds from the regulatory uncertainty in India. But I think we encourage the media to sort of clarify the facts for the less informed individuals.
Indian government has been saying no blockchain, but yes to blockchain, but no to cryptocurrencies.
Yeah.
How relevant is that? And isn't that restricting the whole technology then?
What does blockchain do? Blockchain takes out the middleman from the transaction. So if it takes out the middleman, so for example, it takes out Amazon, and you and I can transact together. Mm. Now the money has to be paid between us. Mm. So this incentive system enables that, right? Now the good thing about this incentive system is the denominations of this incentive system goes down to 18th decimal, which is unlike the rupee, which is only 1 paisa. It goes to only 2 decimals. Mm. So if you and I are trying to do hundreds and thousands of small micro transactions, that cannot happen with the normal digital incentive systems. Mm. So that's why I think this currency or system or the incentive system is very relevant to smart contracts, because it enables micro transactions.
All the best, Abhishek, going forward from here. Thank you so much for taking time.
Thank you so much.